Good day, learners. Today we are going to study how to form the equation of the parabola if its vertex and y-intercept are different. The vertex form of the parabola. So we have this one, y is equal to a, and then we have x minus h to the second power plus k. So the h here plus in this formula in the vertex form, this h is the axis of symmetry which is equal to x. The k there is the lowest point or the minimum point or the maximum point or the highest point if this one is negative. Okay. So the vertex of our parabola is hk. So let us write here the vertex of our parabola. We have the vertex coordinates is equal to the h, which is also the axis of symmetry x, and then the k. Remember class, this one is negative, it means that if our h here is positive, it will be negative there. If this one is negative, it will be positive there. But the k, if this one is positive, that is positive there. If this one is negative, then it is also negative there in our formula. And then the y-intercept. y-intercept. So the y-intercept in coordinate form is, we have here the x is 0, and then our y-intercept is here. This is the y-intercept. That's the y, and the x is equal to 0. So this is in the form of coordinates. Okay, we have the coordinates of our y-intercept 0 and then the y. We need this one and this one so we can form our equation of the parabola, and afterwards we are going to write it in standard form. Now in our graph here class, let us find the coordinates of the critical points. And what are these critical points? The vertex coordinates and y-intercept coordinates. So let's have the vertex here. Where's the vertex? Here. So our vertex is here. There. Let us find the coordinates of our vertex. So in our vertex there, we have our V. So our V is right here. The vertex there class in our graph is equal to first x. The x is negative 1. So we have negative 1. And then the y is 0. So we have negative 1, 0. That is the coordinates of our vertex. What about the coordinates of this one? The y-intercept. So the y-intercept, that intercept there, the coordinates of that one is 0 and negative 3. So this is our x, this is our y, and in our formula here, this negative 1 is our h, which we are going to change its sign, and then the k is 0. So let us substitute negative 1, 0. In our vertex form formula here, so we have y here is equal to a. We don't have yet the value of a, and then parenthesis x, and then copy the minus, and then the h is negative 1. So we have negative 1, and then 2 to the second power, so we have 2 to the second power, and let us just put the k, which is 0. Then we simplify this one. Y is equal to A. Then we have X. And negative times negative is positive. So the positive 1 raised to the second power. Now we are not going to write any more than 0. So we have this one. But it is not yet complete. Why? Because we don't have yet the value of A. So how do we get the value of A? We use now the coordinates of the y-intercept, which is 0 for x and negative 3 for y. So we're just going to substitute the x and y here and solve for A here. So the y here is negative 3. So we have here negative 3 is equal to A. That is the unknown. And then for the x now becomes 0. So we have 0, plus 1, and then square. So only that one. So this one is negative 3 is equal to A times 0 plus 1 is 1. And 1 times 1 is 1. Okay. So what is A times 1? It's A. So our A here plus A is equal to negative 3. So is it correct? How do we know if that one is correct? Negative 3. Look at the graph there. Our graph is opening downward, meaning the A must be negative. So let us now write here the A so we can complete our equation. So we have y again is equal, we have already negative 3 for a. Now this one is a square of binomial. Now how do we multiply binomials? This one is x plus 1 times x plus 1. So the shortcut is we take the square of the first term, copy the sign of the term here. And then the middle term is, you multiply the first term and the second term, and then times 2. So that is the middle term. And the last term is, you get the square of this one, the second term. So here, let's have x times x, square it. So we have x squared. Copy the sign, this is positive. If that one is negative, then place the negative. 1 times x is 1x, or simply x, times 2 is 2x. So here is 2x. And positive 1 times positive 1 is positive 1 or so. And then let us multiply this trinomial by negative 3. So we have y is equal to negative 3x squared minus 6x minus 3, and that is the standard form of our parabolic curve. Okay, number 2 class, we have our graph here. Just like before, we have the vertex form formula for our parabola. So let's have the vertex. Let's find the coordinates of our vertex. So for the vertex, V, so we have that one, X first, what's the X of this one? That is 1, positive 1. So we have 1 here, and then here is negative 3. So we have negative 3. What about the coordinates of the y-intercept? So for the y-intercept, we have this one. So the x of this one is 0. So this is 0. And then y is 1, negative 2. So we have negative 2 here. Okay, let us now substitute this vertex coordinates to our vertex form formula. and y here. Put here plus y and then a, we don't have yet a x a, copy the minus a minus and then the 1, so because this is positive it will be negative here, so I will not put that one anymore inside the parenthesis. So I'll just put here 1 is squared. You see it's positive, now it's negative, so we are correct. Plus, I'm not going to write anymore the plus, so positive, because you have a negative 3 here, so the sign here of our k is negative 3. This one is the lowest point. Okay. After that one, we can square this one to 1. So we have a is equal to y is equal to a, and then square binomial. X times x, x squared minus minus 1 times x. 1x times 2 is 2x. So we have 2x here. Negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1. Parenthesis. And then minus 3. Okay. Now let us find the a. What is our a here? And a must be positive, because our graph is opening upward. Let us use this formula plus and substitute the y-intercept coordinates 0 and negative 2. The x here plus is x and the negative 2 here is the y. We are going to put the x and y here, substitute x and y here and solve for a. Okay, so here y now is negative 2, we have negative 2 and equals, we have a here and then this one, we have our x, and what is our x here? It's 0, so 0 and then minus 1 is squared minus 3. So we have here negative 2 is equal to, what is 0 minus 1? It's negative 1. Negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1. So this one a times 1, because negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1 minus, you know, still minus a, minus 3. So this one is a. We transpose negative 3 here, so negative 3 will be positive here, so we have 3 minus 2 is equal to a, and a here is equal to 1. Okay. So this one now is equal to 1. So 1 times x squared minus 2x plus 1 is the same. So here we have y now, this is 1, okay, 1, so I'm not going to put that one into the 1 here. So this will become x squared minus 2x plus 1 and then the minus 3 here. And finally when we combine like terms, these two, we have y is equal to x squared minus 2x minus 2, and this is our equation in standard form of that parabolic equation.